Hey, it's Fran at the lab, blah, 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 blah. Anyway, I wanted to talk about a video I put up the other day. A lot of strong reactions, and I was really kind of taken aback by the heated comments. So I thought I really had to make a video, sort of supplement and explain some things and answer some very, you know, common comments and questions on that video. So, all right, I'm really on the fence about the unidentified flying objects. I always have been on the fence. Like I said, throughout my life, sometimes I've been on one side of the fence or the other. I've been a skeptic about it, and I poo-pooed it, and I've also been intrigued by it and really engaged in, you know, learning about what people see and everything. But so, a lot of people point to the Thunderfoot videos, and I'm not saying that it's not a good explanation, but it's just that. It's, from my middle ground opinion, and this is what really got me off guard, is that even some people who know me pretty well were commenting pretty negatively about the video. From my middle ground perspective, it's just as arbitrary to say that an object that's just a blob on a radar screen or an infrared camera is, that's definitely a bird. It's just as arbitrary to say that as to say it's an armed drone or an atomic powered zeppelin. There's no evidence to say it's anything. It is, by all definitions, a completely unidentified object. And so my point is that the preponderance of evidence over many decades is that tens of thousands of people, perhaps even millions of people, have seen objects in the sky. Pilots see them. It's on they're caught on cameras, they're caught on radar, the military intercepts them. It's just decades and decades and decades. And so to say that it's Venus or birds or ball lightning, whatever, any one thing can be true. But people have commented, a few of them say, Fran, that's not very Occam's razor of you. But is it? I mean, Occam's razor is something that says, all things being equal, the simplest explanation is usually the right one. Well, if millions of people see objects flying around in the sky and flying saucers and things zipping around and making right angle turns at, you know, Mach 3, what's Occam's razor for that? You know, is the simplest explanation that people are insane, that everybody who sees something unidentified in the sky is mistaken? That wouldn't be Occam's razor. It would be, this is something that people see, it's something that radar tracks, it's something that cameras take pictures of, it's something we should investigate. That's science. But yeah, I think I touched into a very touchy subject where I found that there were some people who commented that, you know, this is interesting and I'd like to know more. I'd like to, you know, like you, Fran, I'd like to know more and I'd like to read that report if it comes out. But there were some people who are just so quick. I mean, there were some comments like, oh, Fran, you know, I've followed you for years, but now, you know, you've completely disappointed me and I'm out of here. Unsubscribe. Fine. But why? You know, what did I say? There's like this emotional element to this that I'm talking about something completely unknown. And that's what it is. It's completely unknown. I'd like to speculate, and in the video I went off and speculated. So, well, if it is this, then this is some ideas that I might have about what we could be looking at. But, you know, if it turns out that it's all birds, that's fine. I'd like to see the the documented evidence of that too. You know, if we can just write it off to say that our airspace is being invaded by migratory birds, you know, every day, that's fine. But, you know, the military has a lot of vested interest in protecting the airspace, and I doubt that they'd be concerned about, you know, flocks of birds every day. I'm sure that birds are a part of it. I'm sure the ball lightning is a part of it, but it's not the whole thing. You know, ever since the Second World War, when more planes ended up in the sky more often than at any other time in our history, ever since the Second World War, pilots have run into objects in the air. And it's funny because all the comments in the, you know, in that video, they're not from pilots. But, you know, being around pilots and flying some myself and everything, I know that, you know, for decades, it is an unspoken thing. You're not supposed to talk about it. But amongst pilots, people who are in the air a lot, it's just a given that these things are out there. Pilots run into them. And there's like every pilot that's been in the air enough has a story about something they ran into. So, yeah, it's worth looking at. It's, you know, and, you know, people point to that video, those videos. Well, I don't think that those videos are conclusive. I think they're compelling, you know. But, like I said, the 60 Minutes video, which a lot of people say they can't see because it's been blocked in some countries. So that I had that problem with BBC stuff, that the BBC blocks stuff. That's why I didn't put it in the video, because I figured no one, you know, the video would just get banned on YouTube if I put 60 Minutes in it. But at the end there, those two Navy pilots, the woman and the man, they were both the pilots of two jets, and they had observers in the back seat. So there was actually four of them in two jets that went to intercept an object. And they talked about, and that last piece that doesn't have any of the comm talk with the long distance thing, that was what they shot, because they had been chasing this object for some time. They intercepted it and got close to it. The one pilot circled down to it, and it was resting right on the surface of the ocean, out to sea, and it was in the middle of this frothing like white water. He said it was a tic-tac shaped object about the size of like a car or a bus, and it was rotating. And he says as he spiraled down and got down at a low altitude, the thing started to spin with him. So he said when he started circling around, the object, which had this north-south trajectory, it started to turn, it started to follow him. And he says, and as he was going down, the object started coming up. And so he got down and like started following the object. And so he said, when I was coming up on the object like this from the bottom and it was up there, he said, it just disappeared. He says, it was right on my nose, this white tic-tac. He says, he came right up under it. He says, it was right on it and it just disappeared. And the woman pilot, who's the wingman, wingwoman, said, yeah, she said, that's exactly what happened. She said, and the guy asked him, he said, so you both saw it? He said, no, I said, there was four of us. You know, we had observers in the back. We all had eyes on it and we all saw it and we talked about it afterwards. He said, and he says, so you think there's something out there? And they said, absolutely. So they both said, without a shadow of doubt, we can tell you that there's something out there and it's really weird. And that was the part that really got me. It wasn't the blurry videotape footage from the gun displays and stuff like that. It's really the sworn testimony of those miserable souls. It's worth investigating. You know, my scientific curiosity is based on the idea that, you know, this is a phenomena and we need to investigate it. And the other thing is people are like, Fran, you know, the supernatural stuff, and you're talking, you're flat earthers and Illuminati and this, you know, your conspiracy. It's like, well, first of all, there's no conspiracy about this. these things are everywhere. I didn't say it in the video, but, you know, years ago, my best friend, a woman who I respected very much, who was in the military, confided in me a very personal story about a very close encounter with an object that was hovering above her for a very long amount of time, several minutes, and she and many other people watched this silver round object, you know, hovering, you know, a few hundred feet in the air above them and moving around and coming down to, you know, where they could see features on it and everything. Her story about that, I thought, was very compelling. It wasn't some psychotic thing. It was seen by many people, and, you know, she didn't know what it was. But I know that it's a common experience, and a common shared experience needs to be explored, because that's what a phenomena is. And this is my last thing about this. People saying, oh, it's supernatural. There is nothing supernatural. There is no supernatural. This is the thing. I'm trying to take the tin hat off of this, you know. It's a human phenomena. It's something people have seen for a long, long time. We need to think about it in a scientific way and investigate it like we do anything else. But there's a stigma attached to it, you know? Nothing is supernatural. Everything that exists is part of nature. If you see something that you can't explain, it's not supernatural, it just defies your explanation. It reveals a part of nature that you are unaware of, or have no model for, or have not ever before seen. That's what it is. So I don't discount the preponderance of evidence that things are flying around in the air. They are. It's true. So my saying in the video that UFOs are real, UFOs are real. They're there. We see them. We track them. They come up on radar. They disappear from radar. Pilots engage with them. So that's not really up to dispute. What are they? We don't know. And I'd like to know. You know, I think we all should want to know what they are. Lastly, I would say that a lot of people put a lot of words into my mouth. I never said the word aliens, and I never suggested that if these objects are craft, that they're piloted. Quite the contrary, I would think that they would not be piloted. Even if they were of extraterrestrial origin, it would not make sense that they would have living organisms in them. That's not what we do. When we investigate other planets, we send robots, and I would expect that these would be just that. They would be robots. And if they were, you know, traveling interdimensionally, like winking in and out, like I suggested could be possible, there wouldn't necessarily be anything alive in it. It would be a lot easier and a lot safer and make a lot more sense to send a robot interdimensionally and retrieve it than to put actual lives at risk doing something like that. I don't think they would be piloted. And the other thing is that in my suggestion of interdimensional sort of projection, you wouldn't have to have a propulsion system. This is the other thing, is that all these pilots, they say these things are under propulsion. Well, maybe they're not under propulsion, because if it's an interdimensional projection, there wouldn't be any propulsion system. It would be moving around at incredible speeds, and we would see it doing maneuvers and such, but it wouldn't be moving in its own space. From the fifth dimensional perspective, if it's a three-dimensional construct that's being maneuvered around in another dimension, in the fifth dimension, it wouldn't be moving around, per se. This is where it gets a little tricky. Like I was saying, you know, it doesn't have sonic booms. And people were saying, well, you don't hear sonic booms from a plane. Well, no, obviously not from a plane. They track these objects on radar. So they track these objects on radar flying over air bases and such, where there would be people on the ground. And they've accumulated that data saying that we've got them flying overhead, and from ground observation, there's no sonic boom. It's not from the air. So yeah, so lots of people are making their own conclusions about what I was saying. But yeah, I'm very open to the idea of being open to whatever possibilities. And as one commenter had put in there, and I think this is the final thing from Arthur C. Clarke, there are only two possibilities. One is that we're alone in the universe. The other is that we are not. And both of these possibilities are equally terrifying. So there you go. Food for thought. I'm going to get back to the electronics. I'm waiting for that report to come out. And if it ever does come out, maybe we'll learn something. Maybe we won't. But I will forever be intrigued by the weird things that people find lying around in the sky. All right, I'm Fran. Thanks to all the patrons for not just like leaving me high and dry for crazy talk. Thank you everyone on the Patreon. I appreciate your support, even when I'm talking about things that might be uncomfortable. So anyway, that's it for this one. I'll be back real soon. Bye. Work. In the lab. Go berserk. my lab. It's where I work.
At the bench again.